We cannot reconstitute all old societies. We can take the spirit of former societies we produce and live by that spirit. That means we must build the family again as a unit. Relate the family to the total community. Trust each other again. Feel safe among each other again. Love each other again. Stop ever referring to each other with derogatory words. And let us remember when Dons were young and history was barely an embryo. In the Nile valleys of Egypt, in the Niger valleys, other parts of Africa, Limpopo and the Zimbabwe, we created the laws and the social thought that would later govern man, who dared to call himself civilized after they had learned from us. The Greeks and the Romans warmed their intellectual hands on the fire that we had created. And except for what Africans had created earlier, there had been no Rome and no Greece. There was a time you stood at the center of the world. Realize there was a period of sovereignty and independence in your history when you were the major influences of the world and gave guidance to the world without oppressing anyone, without being arrogant enough to take anyone's country. And you gave the world some safety and a new humanity. Once you recover your confidence, read your history properly, train your children to remember these things and build them again, you can say, we are capable of starting a revolution that will change the world. We need each one of us a partner in this revolution. So I suggest that you find a mirror and don't move from the mirror until you lack what is staring back at you. If you don't love yourself, the love you have for other people is worthless. What you need to do if you are serious, if you are in doubt, you will say, I will start my revolution to change the world tomorrow. But if you are serious and confident about it, you will say, the revolution to change the world starts with me, and it starts right now. Thank you.